Today, we're going to be looking at cowboy songs, some of the favorites of America of all times. First off, if you recognized it, yeah, I was playing my harmonica. Harmonicas were one of the cowboys' favorite instruments because they were very easy to carry along. You could just stick it right here in your pocket and go after those cows. But they didn't call them cows. Would you believe they called them dogies? Not doggies, dogies. Get along, little doggie. Another favorite instrument for the cowboys was the guitar. And probably the most famous cowboy song of all time was this song, Home on the Range. Sing it with me. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Nice job. We're going to do something with this. This song is in an unusual meter. Instead of being in two or four, like we're used to in class, it's in three. And we're going to go one, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. I'd like you to try patting one, two, three, one, two, three, while I play the song. See if you can play it and or pat it and sing at the same time. Let's try it again now. Ready? Here you go. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Here we go. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam and the deer in the seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Good job. Nice job. That was in 3 meter. Now let's look at another song. Now this song is in 4, and it's called Old Texas. It's another favorite old cowboy song. Cowboys did a lot of their work in Texas. All the way from Texas, would you believe, even down into Mexico, that whole area at one time was just like one great big prairie, and the cowboys would go back and forth between Texas and Mexico. Well, over time, what happened is that farmers came along, and farmers didn't like all those cows, because there's not one or two, there would be thousands of cows that the cowboys would herd over this pasture land that was government land. Well, then the farmers bought some of the land and they put fences on it. Well, all of a sudden the cows couldn't go across that land. And some of the cowboys became a little discouraged. So they came up with this song. I'm going to leave old Texas now. They've got no for the longhorn cow. They've plowed and fenced my cattle range, and the people there are all so strange. Now I'm going to stop there, because there is a way that you can help sing this song. Oh yeah. Because this song is meant to have echoes. So when I sing, I'm going to leave, then you sing, I'm going to leave old Texas now, old Texas now. And we'll go back and forth, okay? We'll do that for the whole song. Here we go. I'm going to leave, I'm going to leave old Texas now, old Texas now. They've got no use, they've got no use for the longhorn cow, for the longhorn cow. They've plowed and fenced, they've plowed and fenced my cattle range, my cattle range. And the people there, and the people there are all so strange, are all so strange. I'll take my horse, I'll take my horse, I'll take my rope, I'll take my rope, and hit the trail, and hit the trail, upon a lope, upon a lope. Now, a lope is one of the ways that a horse moves. They have different levels. They have walk and trot and canter. Lope is one of those ways. It's pretty fast, but not super fast, not a flat out run. Well, we have some more. Now, this time I'm not going to give you your part. I'll nod at you and you sing it then. Ready? Say adios to the Alamo and turn my head toward Mexico. I'll make my home on the wide, wide range, where the people there are not so strange. The hard, hard ground shall be my bed, and my saddle seat shall hold my head, shall hold my head. Yeah, good job. That's an echo song, so we go back and forth to make a big melody. Very nice. Let's go on. There's another echo song. Now, this isn't really a cowboy song, but it's kind of funny. There is a book even. I mean, this song is at least, we think at least 140 years old. That's how far back we can find the words to it. It might even be older. Now, this one is silly because it's about a man and his goat. And there's a bad joke right in the first verse. See if you can get it. There was a man, there was a man. Now, please take note, now, please take note. There was a man, there was a man who had a goat, who had a goat. He loved that goat, he loved that goat. Indeed, he did. Just like a kid, just like a kid. Did you get the play on words? Yeah, he loved the goat like a kid. And if you don't get the play on the words, a kid is a baby goat. So they're kind of being silly there. Okay, here we go. Verse 2. Bill Grogan's goat, Bill Grogan's goat was feeling fine, was feeling fine. Ate three red shirts, ate three red shirts right off the line, right off the line. Bill took a stick, Bill took a stick, gave him a whack, gave him a whack, and tied that goat, tied that goat to the railroad track, to the railroad track. Aw, poor goat. You can tell Bill's kind of mad at him, isn't it? Well, wonder what happened. The whistle blew, whistle blew. The train grew nigh, the train grew nigh. Bill Grogan's goat, Bill Grogan's goat was doomed to heaved a sigh, he heaved a sigh of awful pain, of awful pain. Coughed up those shirts, coughed up those shirts, and flagged the train, and flagged the train. That is one smart goat. Now, some of you are like, I don't get this song at all, Mrs. White. What's going on? Well, back in the train days, okay, remember, they don't have cell phones. They don't have telephones. They don't have a way to talk to a moving train. So there were some signals they would use. One of them was something red, and they'd wave it, and that would tell the engineer he needed to stop. It meant that there was danger, like maybe the tracks had washed out. Something bad had happened. So this goat was pretty smart. Here he'd ate Bill's shirts, coughed them up, and then managed to wave them so that the train stopped and he didn't get hurt. Smart goat. Let's do that verse 3 one more time. The whistle blew, the train grew nigh. Bill Grogan's goat was doomed to die. He heaved a sigh of awful pain, coughed up those shirts, and flagged the train, flagged the train. That's right. Okay, so today we did two things. We did 3 meter with 1, 2, 3, and we learned about echo songs, where one person goes and then the other people echo the same line. Well, I hope you had fun with our songs today. I'm looking forward to seeing you again. For now, take care. Goodbye.